Hi everyone, welcome to Sherry's show. Today I have a special guest. She's one of my very good friends, Sherry. Say hi, Sherry.
Hi, everyone.
So Sherry, she actually called me. Sherry's cooking with Sherry. She said, Sherry, I want to cook with you. And I said, what? Let's do it together, girlfriend. So we're actually cooking together. And she has, what are we cooking today?
We're going to make spanakopita, Greek food. Spanakopita basically is spinach pie. And we're going to make some dip for it, which is tzatziki, with yogurt, cucumber, dill,
Perfect.
And garlic.
Perfect. Oh my God, you have a beautiful, cute house with your decoration of a Christmas tree. And look, it's snowing today.
It's beautiful,
oh my goodness,
isn't
it's beautiful.
It?
And you have a golf course behind your yard, right?
I know, isn't it lovely?
It's beautiful.
What a view.
Oh, yes. So what's cooking today?
So we're gonna make some Greek food. We're gonna make spanakopita and some yummy dip for it.
Yum. So let's just go with the ingredients.
So for spanakopita, we're gonna need spinach. We can use fresh spinach, we can use frozen spinach.
And you have fresh spinach?
I have fresh and I will show you how we use it. Butter, or you can use olive oil, eggs, feta cheese, and phyllo pastry. Mm. And of course, seasoning. For our dip, we need Greek yogurt or yogurt, any yogurt.
Plain yogurt, right?
Plain yogurt, yeah. And I use low fat, or no fat actually. We got cucumber, garlic, dill, garlic. And also I add a little bit of mayonnaise that I explain later.
Ooh, yum yum. So let's do it.
Let's do it. Kay. So first let's open our pastry.
They can buy this pastry anywhere, right?
This can be bought at any store and in the freezer section. You can keep it in the freezer and you defrost it to use it. And if you have extra, you can put it back in the freezer for the next time.
Oh, wow.
I'm using fresh spinach, but if you don't want to make it easy, this is baby spinach, you know. And I'm going to quickly blanch them so it's a little bit cooked. But if you want to make it easy, you can use frozen spinach as well. No problem. So let's blanch this first.
Sure.
And then we can cool it down so we can wrap our spanakopita.
Perfect. Sherry, this recipe, it's a Greek recipe, but I believe it's your own recipe that you cook?
It is. I make it my own way, so it's fast and easy, you know. Too much traditional, ways, it takes time.
Exactly.
Time consuming, right? But this is quick. People can cook it in their toaster oven.
Especially when you work and you come back from work and you just want to make something fast and easy, there you have it,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Under 30 minutes, you
That's
can
right.
have a lovely meal.
Exactly.
You know? So yeah, no, it is my own version. Yes, okay,
perfect,
absolutely.
Perfect, perfect. And I know that you love cooking.
I do.
Yes.
I do. I love cooking. I love baking. So
yeah,
it's fun.
I know that. Yeah. And then you've been cooking since when? Since you were...
Since I was 13.
There
my
you are.
Grandmother,
like me.
My grandmother taught me how to cook.
Yeah, yeah.
All the different techniques and stuff.
Yeah.
And then my youngest son became chef. So I learned a lot of techniques, from him too.
Yeah.
But it is
We should
always
have
my
him own. On the show
we
too.
We should. He's very
yeah,
good.
Next yeah. time we're going to have her son coming to our show.
To cook professional
exactly.
yeah. But it's fun to make your own ways, you know, because it goes with our family, the way they eat.
Perfect.
Right?
Yes. Yeah, so. Yeah. Yeah. Your own taste.
Exactly.
So what are we doing right now?
We're going to add some salt to our boiling water. And then not too much, just a little bit. And then we're just going to quickly blanch our spinach, not too long, and then we drain it as soon as they wilt down a bit. No, we don't want it to lose the vibrant green color, right?
Of course,
you don't want to do that. So let's just pull them out.
I can smell the spinach,
right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this one is very good because it can be served as appetizer or as main dish. Like right now what we're doing, we can serve it as main dish, right?
Exactly.
So there we go. And we just turn this off. And we're gonna let this cool down. And then we can chop it. So, while we're waiting for the spinach to cool down, we're gonna make our dip.
Okay, perfect. Okay. Okay. Let's do it.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna, I'm a bit lazy, so I use machine.
Well, you know, it's always good to have, you know, something, you know, convenient.
Exactly. I'm just gonna grate it. Yeah. And I'm gonna grate the garlic with it as well.
Okay. 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 So this is the tzatziki?
This is a tzatziki, yes. Easy, right?
Yeah, I want one of those too.
I know, it's the best. Yeah. And I like garlic, so I'm gonna put a lot of garlic.
Oh, you're like me. I love garlic.
Also, what happens is when the garlic sits in the yogurt, it just smells really good.
Yeah. You're making me hungry.
It's very juicy. So we get rid of some of it.
Yeah.
And then we mix it. So now we're gonna add the rest of our ingredient. Sorry.
Yeah, so that's the yogurt.
That's our yogurt.
I can smell the garlic already.
Yes. I'm gonna put the whole tub of yogurt in there, okay?
Yeah, because we want lots of
right? It's so good that you don't want to make a little, right?
Exactly.
And also it's a great dip. You can eat it with anything, like even with chips and nachos and stuff.
Yeah,
you can, right?
Yeah,
I mean, it's Greek, but you don't have to, right?
Exactly.
And then I'm going to add some dill, not too much.
Yeah.
This is the same fresh dill that I chopped.
So let's say, is that a tablespoon, one tablespoon that you're putting in, or one half a tablespoon?
You know, I usually cook by eye because of the many years I've been cooking, but if
for
you want to
younger
see it,
exactly,
one tablespoon.
One tablespoon.
Because it smells really good.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And of course, season it, but I don't put pepper in here. If you want to put pepper, use white pepper.
Okay, it's optional.
Right? Yeah, so just a little bit salt. Some people like salty food, they add more.
Maybe this one is a half a teaspoon.
I did half a teaspoon, right? But if you want more, you can. So you just mix this well.
I love dill in there too.
Yeah. Now some people, as you mentioned earlier, my recipes are my own. Like I do it the way I like, but some people put lemon juice in here. I don't. But what I do though, instead of putting lemon juice, I add a little bit of mayonnaise.
Oh.
So it's a bit of
it gives you like a little bit of
it does a kick, you know?
Oh, I see.
And make it, I don't know, and make it a little bit creamier,
Yeah.
So this is done and we can just, it's, you know, wrap it up, put it in the fridge to chill, and also the
ingredients
just go together,
melt together, exactly.
Yeah, and then while this is chilling, we can make our Spanakopita.
Ooh, I'm
all so
excited.
Yeah. Okay, let's do it.
Let's do it. So what's next?
So now we're going to chop a little bit, chop our spinach so it's not too big.
Yeah.
It's not a bad idea to squeeze a little bit extra juice out
take
of it,
the juice out,
right?
Yeah.
Not too much, it's okay.
Yeah. So how much spinach do you use, Sherry?
For this recipe right now that we're making it in a small
portion,
it's actually a pretty big portion. But it's a small dish, right?
Okay.
So we can use one bag.
Okay. So that's for like a 1 pound of a spinach?
I think it is, yes.
Okay.
The bags are 1 pound.
Okay.
So this just needs to be roughly chopped. So I'm just gonna transfer it into my
bowl
dish here.
Yeah.
Actually, if you don't mind holding this for me,
I'm
gonna beat the egg first. So I like to use one egg. I don't want it too eggy because when you put too many eggs, it gets
soggy or?
It doesn't get soggy, it becomes thicker.
Oh, I see.
And I don't want it to be like that.
Okay.
I personally don't,
right?
Even though Spanakopita is actually a spinach pie, but, so one egg. I'm just gonna, just to mix it. And then we're gonna add a cup of feta cheese. This is crumbled feta cheese, right? So we're just going to add that in there.
I love feta cheese.
If you like feta cheese, you can add more. It's okay, you know? And we just
but
mix
this
it.
This is how much you need.
This is how much you need. Now, I'm not going to season this because this cheese is actually salty. So this, and now, if you don't mind passing me the spinach, we add that.
I'm your little helper.
You are my gorgeous, gorgeous helper. There you go, darling. So that's that. And we just kind of mix it up. It's not... Again, if you like egg, you can add more egg. If you want more spinach, you can. This is what I like.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Easy peasy, done.
Yeah, wow.
Done.
Yeah.
So now we're going to wrap it. So now we need to butter our dish. Mm-hmm. I like butter. If you don't want to use butter, it's fine. You can use olive oil.
So you melted your butter earlier?
I did. I melt the butter in microwave. Mm-hmm. And I use plastic brush because the hair brush, the hair comes off.
Ugh, I don't believe
that. And then you have that in your bite.
So yeah.
Just little tips. So first, I'm going to grease my pan. Mm-hmm. Just so. Because this is the bottom of our pie and we want it to come off. If it's not properly greased, it will stick.
In the pan.
Exactly.
Yes.
This is a very delicate dough. Mm-hmm. A lot of people like to put damp towel on it so it won't dry. Mm. I don't because it takes more time. You keep have to lift the towel and all that.
And is that the dough that you bought? That's the phyllo pastry that
I got from a superstore, but you can get it from anywhere. Everybody has it.
There you
go. Inexpensive, very easy. Mm-hmm. You can make pastry with it. So now we're going to layer our pan. Mm-hmm. Doesn't matter if it tears, it's gonna all stick together.
Of course.
It's not that big a deal, right?
Don't panic, you guys.
No, it's not brain surgery. It's easy peasy, you know. The whole point is for it to be easy and
quick, right?
So you just layer. I like to put some butter in between. You don't need too much.
Yeah, just a bit, yeah.
Also, it helps you to kind of put it in its place.
Yes,
do you know
yes.
What I mean?
Yeah, I totally do, yeah.
See, it kind of helps you. So the bottom needs to be multi-layer because that's the part that you want. See, now they're stuck together.
Yeah.
That's the part that you want it to be thicker, right? Mm-hmm. It's the base. It holds, right? So that was a bit much. I think I probably put like 8 or 10 layers. Right?
Layers on the bottom? Yeah.
I think so, right? Okay. Because you want it to hold.
Yes.
Let's see if this one's going to be nice to us. The other one drift apart.
There we go. That's better.
Not too bad, right?
Yeah.
And you can just fold it over. So like you just
butter it and then fold it the other side.
Yeah. Exactly. And try to even it. So if you fold it from this side, next time fold it from the other side, right?
Uh-huh. But it's yummy. I think the guys behind the camera are getting hungry too, Shay. What do you think?
Right? I think so. soon, guys.
Yeah. Well, we gotta taste it first, and then we'll let you guys try. Right. Normally, it's the other way around, right?
Waiting for the cheers.
Ooh!
Oh, the last word. Meatos.
Yes, we have a surprise at the end.
We do. Okay. So now I'm going to spread the whole thing at once in there.
Perfect.
You don't need to layer it.
Yes.
You just put it all in there. But yeah, so see like some parts there's more cheese, some is less. It's okay.
Yeah.
But if you want, if you're picky, you can
just
do that too, right?
Yeah.
So it's kind just of push it down, right? Mm-hmm. Try to make it even.
Yummy.
Simple,
it looks
right?
So nice too.
Looks pretty, no?
Yeah.
The colors, right?
Okay. Exactly.
So now we're done. Now all we need to do is layer the top. Right? And
perfect.
And then we put it in the oven.
And then how long in the oven?
So I'm actually going to cook this in a toaster oven. So
nice.
It's easy for everyone to do at home.
Yeah.
You don't have to do it in the oven.
Mm-hmm.
You know, honestly, I do it by eye because what you need is for it to be golden.
Mm-hmm.
You need the color to be golden, right?
Yeah.
So,
so let's say for our young audiences,
yes.
If they want to cook it and they just want to know exactly.
I think it takes probably about 15 minutes.
15 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay, not bad. Yeah.
But we're going to time it now, so
Exactly.
Yeah. See, again, it doesn't really matter for the little layering, right? But then at the end, the last part, we want to
how many layers do you put on top?
I think probably about 4 or 5.
Mm-hmm. And you don't butter it anymore?
Yes, we do. Mm-hmm. Yes, we do, but not every layer, which is fine. Now, as you do that, try to push it down.
Because then it's going to stick together, right?
The reason you don't need to butter it so much on top is because the bottom part, you want it to stick together. Butter is sticking it, make it stick together, right? Mm-hmm, it's like mm-hmm. like a glue kind of thing.
Like a glue, yeah.
Yeah, but I know
it's a good glue, though.
It's a yummy glue. But I know some people don't butter at all. Mm. I like to butter it, so we just, mm-hmm. There you go. Couple of more, and then we're done. Mm-hmm.
I know that you love traveling, too, and you've been to Greece so many times, too?
To Santorini only, but yes. To Greece. Mm. I love it. I'm going to cut the extra, mm-hmm. and I'm going to cut it to the shape you like. What I'm going to do is...
Cut it in half,
and you want to go all the way to the end.
Yes.
Because when it's cooked, if you cut it, it's going to break. It's going to fall off,
yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So you go gently all the way to the end. And you want a very sharp knife, mm-hmm. like a sharp paring knife, right? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And then another one, right? Now, spanakopita is usually wrapped mm-hmm. in a triangle shape, right? So I didn't wrap it, I did the easy way, right? Mm-hmm. So right now, I'm going to cut it into triangle to resemble.
Exactly.
Right?
Yes, yeah.
Okay, so we're done. And that's it.
Yum, that looks
so... And it goes in the oven now.
Yeah, that looks beautiful. Wow.
Now we need to just put it in the toaster oven. Mm-hmm. I'm going to preheat the oven for a little bit.
Yeah,
This toaster oven works just like a regular oven, so it's at 350.
350 Fahrenheit, yeah.
Yeah, but with oven, it tells you that it's 350. This doesn't, right? Mm-hmm. So it's okay as long as it's warmed up. Mm-hmm. You don't want to put it in the cold oven because it just takes longer.
Of course.
Nothing bad happens to the food.
Of course.
It just takes longer.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So I'm going to preheat the oven and then we put it in there.
Perfect.
Okay.
Have it, you guys. And what did you make?
So we made spanakopita with tzatziki on the side to dip in.
Wow, let's try it. I can't wait to try it, you guys.
Let's try it. Me too. Oh, actually, I'm gonna eat with my hand.
Are you?
It's okay, yes.
Well, I'm gonna do the same. But how are you gonna dip it?
The crunch.
Oh my god, you ate faster than I did.
I'm hungry. Yum.
My god.
Yum.
Crispy outside, soft inside, yummy.
Yummy dance,
let's do it. Oh my god,
love it. I'm gonna dip it again. Yum.
My goodness,
this is so good.
Heaven. Here you have it, you guys.
Spanakopita.
So Sherry made it very easy for us to make. Please make it and send the picture to us, right?
Absolutely.
Until next time.
Cheers.
Thanks for watching, you guys. If you like this video and you want to see more, please subscribe the channel and leave a comment below. I love to read your comments.